heirs of the partner, that is the legal heirs of the partners, would like a settlement of the account of the partner who has died, they would have to be paid the capital balance of the partner who has died. They would like a share in goodwill. They would like to get share in accumulated profits and reserve. They would ask the partnership firm to revalue the assets and liabilities to get share in profits and losses. They would also like a share in joint life policy, and up to the date of death, whatever profits have been earned by the firm, in that also they would like to get a share. So the person who has died, his legal heirs, his successors, would like to take the amount what is due from the firm. It will include capital balance, goodwill balance, accumulated profits and reserves, revaluation profits and losses, joint life policy amount, and also the profit up to the date of death. Now, if a partner dies, a huge amount has to be paid to settle his capital account. A huge amount. Capital balance, reserves, joint life policy, goodwill, sharing, profits. If so much amount has to be paid, the firm may not have liquid cash immediately to repay the entire amount. And if the successor demands, the firm has to sell the assets, make it into cash, and settle the capital account of the partner who has died. Okay? But if the assets are liquidated, the business will come to an end. So the partners don't want the business to come to an end on the death of a particular partner. So to insure against that, what they do is they go to an insurance company and buy a joint life policy. Suppose joint life policy is for 10 lakh. That means this is the assured sum. The policy provides if any of the partner dies, the insurance company will pay 10 lakh. And the policy period is 15 years. Every year you have to pay 60,000 as premium. Every year you have to pay 60,000 as premium. If during these 15 years, you say 50,000. And the insurance company provides that if you pay 50,000 per annum, during the next 15 years, if anything happens, if any one of the partner dies, we are going to give you 10 lakh. This annual premium we have to pay every year for 15 years. If anything happens during these 15 years, the insurance company is going to pay 10 lakh rupees to the firm. If any of the partner dies, any of the partner dies, the insurance company is going to pay that amount. Now, this is called as the policy period. This is called as the premium amount. And this is called as the assured sum. Now, suppose after paying 5 years premium, you want to discontinue the policy. The firm is not in a position to pay this 50,000 every year. After paying for 5 years, they want to discontinue the policy, they want to cancel the policy. Then the insurance company may say, boss, we'll give you 1 lakh. This is called as surrender value. If I'm not able to complete the policy term, and in between, if I want to cancel the policy, after 5 years, I'm going to get this amount, that is called as surrender value. If I want to cancel first year, surrender value will be nil. If I want to cancel second year, nil. LIC, Life Insurance Company of India, doesn't pay any surrender value if the policies are surrendered in the first 2 years. From third year onwards, you'll start getting some surrender value. As the policy becomes old, the surrender value will also keep increasing. Earlier the cancellation, lower the amount you'll get. Later the cancellation, the more amount of surrender value you are going to get. Okay. So now, how to deal with this joint life policy in our books of accounts? Apart from joint life policy, the firm can buy individual policies also. Suppose there are three partners, partner A, partner B, partner C. The firm can buy individual life insurance policies for A 10 lakh, assured sum, for B 5 lakh, assured sum, for C 5 lakh, assured sum. Instead of buying one policy for all the partners, they can go for individual life insurance policies also 10 lakh, 5 lakh and 5 lakh assured sum. Premium for these policies will be paid by the firm. Firm will pay the premium. Suppose A dies, the firm will receive 10 lakh. If B dies, firm will receive 5 lakh. If C dies, the firm will receive 5 lakh. If only A dies, the firm will receive 10 lakh. What about the policies of B and C? No continuation. The successors of A will say, boss, surrender these policies. Surrender these policies. Whatever amount has been received on the life insurance policy of A and whatever is received by surrendering B and C's policy, entire amount belongs to the firm. It doesn't belong to an individual partner. If anything happens, suppose A is dying, the firm gets 10 lakh. A's son cannot say this entire 10 lakh belongs to me. This 10 lakh belongs to the firm. Why? Policy was purchased out of firm's money. Even on his death, whatever amount is received, this amount will belong to firm. So now A's son will feel bad. He'll say, my father has died and the firm has got 10 lakh. You are saying it belongs to the firm. Then what about your policies? Surrender those policies. Whatever amount comes, it also belongs to the firm. I'll also get a share in that. So if there is one policy, there is no question of surrendering other policies. But if there are individual policies, the partner who has died on his policy, we are going to get assured sum. On the remaining policies, we have to surrender those policies and take the surrender value. Or notionally surrender the policies and bring the surrender values into calculation. The same policies can be continued. Assume that the policies have been surrendered and consider the policies to continue. So let us do accounting for joint life policy. Write down. Yes. Write down first method, accounting for joint life policy. I feel more happy teaching the board than you people, because no, when we are teaching, you people are busy in your work. You keep talking to your friends, you keep writing something, you keep playing games. You feel as if you are not part of the classroom, no? I feel it is better I also teach to the board. I keep noticing you people when you are sitting in the classroom. What do you do, people? Sitting behind, you just keep talking to each other, play video games. Like small kids. Zamane mein we used to play video games with a video game player. Now you are having a smartphone. You are only playing video games in the classroom. So that is how we also feel when we are teaching and you are not listening to us. Minimum common sense should be applied in the classroom. Write down expense method, joint life policy. Expense method, right on. Under this method, premium paid is treated as expense. Not carried to the balance sheet. Entries. Scheme of entries. 1. When insurance premium is paid, joint life policy premium account letter to bank account joint life policy account data, joint life policy premium account data to bank account, amount of premium paid. Amount of premium paid. Next, when it is transferred to P&L account, P&L account data to joint life policy premium account. P&L account data to joint life policy premium account. Next, when death happens and policy amount is recovered, when death happens and policy money is recovered, what is entry will pass? Bank account data to joint life policy account. Bank account data to joint life policy account. Right, assured sum. The entry has to pass with the assured sum. We are treating whatever amount has been received as a gain. Right below that entry, whatever is received is considered as a gain by the firm. Whatever is received is considered as a gain by the firm. Right on entry. When the gain is shared, when the gain is shared among all partners, among all partners in their old profit sharing ratio, pass entry joint life policy account data, joint life policy account data, joint life policy account data to all partners capital account. In old profit sharing ratio, is a gain, it is shared among all partners in their old profit sharing ratio. Next, when policy is surrendered, when policy is surrendered, money can be received on two occasions: death of a partner and surrender of policy. Write down. Write down. Entry. Bank account data to joint life policy account. bank account at R2, joint life policy account. Surrender value. Below that entry you'll write, the amount received is a gain for the firm. Write on entry, joint life policy account at R2, correct or no? Yes, when certain amount is distributed, sir. When the above amount is distributed, joint life policy account at R2, joint life policy account at R2. Joint life policy account at R2. All partners capital account in old profit sharing ratio. Amount paid is treated as expense. Whatever amount is received is treated as income or gain. Next, when joint life policy is treated as an asset. Second scheme of entries, when joint life policy is treated as an asset, under this method, premium paid, under this method, premium paid is treated as an expenditure to purchase an asset. Under this method, premium paid is treated as an expenditure to purchase an asset. It is shown in the balance sheet asset side. It is shown in the balance sheet asset side at surrender value. If book value is more than surrender value, the difference should be transferred to P&L account. If book value is more than surrender value, the difference is transferred to P&L account. Write down entries. 1. When premium is paid, entry, joint life policy account retired to bank account. Joint life policy account at R2, bank account. When policy premium is paid, next, when surrender value is lower than book value. Listen to me. Suppose you have paid 50,000 as premium, but at the end of the year when you want to show it in the balance sheet, the insurance company says surrender value is nil. You have paid 50, insurance company says surrender value is nil. You cannot show this asset now at 50,000 in your balance sheet because you know surrender value is only 0. In such case, entire 50,000 has to be written off by transferring it to the profit and redundant. P&L account at R2, joint life policy account. Profit and loss account at R2, joint life policy account. The amount of write-off. How much should be written off? The amount of write-off. Next. So what you should do is, you have to find out what is the book value, what is surrender value on balance sheet day. If book value is more than surrender value, the amount transferred to the P&L account. Okay. Next. When partner dies, an assured sum is received. When a partner dies, an assured sum is received. Assured sum. Policy amount is received. You read? Entry. You have an asset now, no? In your books, joint life policy asset. Give it to the insurance company. Take policy amount. Entry. Bank account at R2, joint life policy asset account. Bank account at R2, joint life policy asset account. Because of this entry, asset account is now credited with the assured sum. Till now it was debited with cost or surrender value. Now it is credited with the assured sum. The difference represents profit or loss, which has to be now shared among all partners in their old profit sharing ratio. Write down. Right. The joint life policy account, debit side shows cost, and it is now credited with assured sum. Joint life policy asset account, debit side shows cost, and it is now credited with assured sum. The difference represents profit. Difference represents profit to be shared among all partners in old profit sharing ratio. Completed. Write on entry. See, debit side it is showing 50, credit side 10 lakh. The difference will be profit. So 950,000 has to be now shared among the old partners, all partners including their, including a partner who has died and the remaining partner, read on the entry. Joint life policy, asset account, etc. Joint life policy, asset account, etc. 2. All partners, capital account, credit. All partners, capital account, credit in old profit sharing ratio. Debit side 50 you have, credit side 10 lakhs you have. How to close this account?
Debit and
debit this account and give credit to all partners in their old profit sharing ratio. Read on next. If policy is surrendered, if policy is surrendered, the amount received should be credited to joint life policy asset account. Policy surrendered, amount received should be credited to joint life policy asset account. The difference in the account represents profit or loss. The difference in the account represents profit or loss to be shared in old profit sharing ratio among the partners. It should be shared among all partners in their old profit sharing ratio. Did you understand? Same entry will be passed. Entry will be like same above. Of the board. If book value is 50, surrender value is also 50. No profit, no loss. Suppose we get surrender value of 60,000, then that 10,000 has to be shared among the all partners in their old profit sharing ratio. This is called as which method? Joint life policy assets method, where we treat the joint life policy as an asset. Next. Fund method. Fund. It's a hypothetical situation. It's a hypothetical situation. If you get more than what is there, book value will always be written down to center value. Book value is sum of premium paid, but at the end of the year, every year you are comparing it with surrender value. If there is any difference, you are writing it off. No? Next. Write on reserve method, joint life policy, inside fund method, or we also call it as joint life policy reserve method. It's same like sinking fund. Ship will sink. I'm going to start 11th group 2 accounts. You will again see sinking fund in action, debenture redemption fund account. How many of you know properly sinking fund concept? Half you are saying sinking fund concept. Very good, only few people. Why? You have not learned this in CPT?
No, sir.
Chawan.
Plus.
Singing fund. You are not there.
I am not perfect, sir.
You are not?
Perfect.
Perfect in singing fund. Okay, let me then teach you again singing fund. Write down. It's a part of your notability. Tikku tikku. Right on. Fundamental. First entry. When premium is paid. When premium is paid. Entry. Joint life policy account data. Joint life policy account data to bank account. Next, when at the end of the year an amount equal to annual premium is appropriated, when at the end of the year an amount equal to annual premium is appropriated from profits. Pass an entry P&L appropriation account data to joint life policy reserve account. P&L appropriation account data to joint life policy reserve account or joint life policy fund account. So listen to me, this is how we are going to do. Every year some profits will be set aside, cash will be invested in the joint life policy, in the joint life policy issued by the insurance company. Every year out of profits, the amount will be set aside, that amount will be paid to the insurance company as premium. That is called as fund accounting. We did fund accounting, no? In non-profit organizations. No, don't say you are not done. I'll break your neck. Building fund, library fund. Similar to that only. Out of profits, amount are transferred to a fund. The cash relating to the fund is invested in purchasing a joint life policy. Continue. But the difference is, premium will be paid at the beginning of the year, appropriation will happen at the end of the year. Next, for adjustment of difference between, for adjustment of difference between book value and surrender value. See, in this method also, joint life policy asset you have, joint life policy fund you have. Joint life policy fund appears on balance sheet liability side. Joint life policy asset appears on balance sheet asset side. So when you are showing it in balance sheet asset side, you have to compare it with surrender value. If book value is more than surrender value, the difference should be written off. Write on the entry. Entries. Joint life policy fund account data to joint life policy asset account. Written off but not debited to P&L account. It is debited to the joint life policy reserve. The amount is written off, the difference, but it is not transferred to P&L account. It is debited to the joint life policy reserve. fund increases, asset increases. Asset decreases, fund decreases. Fund increases, asset increases. Asset decreases, fund decreases. You can remember this point. Next. Next. For realization of policy money. For realization of policy money on death of a partner. You cannot directly take it to the reserve account. Credit it to, first of all, the asset account. The profit from the asset account will be transferred to the reserve account. Entire reserve will be shared among all the partners in old profit sharing ratio. Right on. On realization of policy money on the death of a partner. Right? Amount collected is credited to asset account, joint life policy asset account. Amount collected is credited to joint life policy asset account. We pass an entry. Bank account debtor to joint life policy asset account. Bank account debtor to joint life policy asset account. How much amount? On the death, no, policy amount. Assured sum. Assured sum. Next. Next. When the credit balance in joint life policy asset is transferred to joint life policy reserve. So just imagine joint life policy asset is showing a debit balance of 50,000. But when you sell the asset, then you give it to the insurance company, they give you 10 lakh. Debit 50, credit 10 lakh. There's a huge credit balance in joint life policy asset account. It should be transferred to joint life policy reserve. Okay. What is entry you pass?
JLP asset account debtor to
JLP asset account debtor to JLP reserve account. Joint life policy asset account debtor to joint life policy reserve account. Okay. Next. When credit balance in reserve is shared among all partners. When credit balance in joint life policy reserve is shared among all partners. And credit balancing joint life policy reserve is shared among all partners. Entry joint life policy reserve account debtor to all partners capital account in old profit sharing ratio. Go through the scheme of entries once again.